Welcome back to Glendale, Arizona, the Jobbing.com Arena. As we continue with After Hours, and we're pleased to have with us now the NHL's king of social media, self-confessed grocery stick, which we'll explain later. Paul Bissonnette of the Phoenix Coyotes has 160,000 followers. And
who's counting?
We're looking at it this way. If we can get two-thirds of them to watch, then we'll have a good audience.
A
tweet out right now.
I just did. It just said right After Hours.
Okay, well, we'll see what kind of reaction.
You guys got to get a new name for the show. I was creeped out. I was like, what's going on here?
Okay, on that topic, you sent a tweet out yesterday to say you were going to be on After Hours. What's it all about? You see, and I just refuse to believe that you didn't know anything about this show, being so media savvy.
No, I did.
Of course.
It reminded me of City TV when they had that baby blue a little bit, and I was like, whoa, what's going on here?
There's a lot of that in the show.
All the creepers know what I'm talking about out there.
Here's a tweet from Craig Boschman. Ask Biz who would shoot behind him in the shootout order.
La Barbara. Our backup goalie. I don't know. He's got a pretty good shot, though. Yeah. Oh. Can a goalie even shoot? Is that even legal?
I think anybody could.
I don't believe it is.
Is it? No, okay. Whatever.
That's a good question.
Well, that's good for me, then.
Tweet that. See what happens.
Yeah, let's find out what we get back.
All right. Before we have a look at some of your sample tweets, you've sent out 4,600 tweets in 14 months. Have you got that smartphone, that iPhone in your hand 24/7?
Well, some days, like on game days, I refuse to tweet. I rarely look at it on game days.
Not allowed to 2 hours before the game, right?
But even before that, you didn't, right?
Right. Like last year, I kind of made up my own rule. I was just like, you know, let's be professional about it. Even whether I was playing or not, I just wouldn't. It was kind of like my escape. And then sometimes I'll go in spurts where I won't tweet for, you know, 2 days. And people are like, where are you? What happened to this guy? It's like, oh, geez, sorry. Sorry for breathing.
Let's have a look at at a sample of some of your recent tweets.
Okay.
The first one, if you added up all the ice time I get this season, it would be longer than Kim Kardashian's marriage.
Fact.
All right.
Maybe. I said if you include warm-up, though. So.
I found shampooing my armpit hair helps with my sweating problem. Does anyone else do this? You see, there is a practical purpose.
Exactly.
Actually, and a lot of people do, and a girl actually sent me a scientific reason why that would make sense.
Excellent.
And why is that?
Yeah.
Well, because I guess soap just kind of like, I don't know. She was smart and I wasn't. I was like, okay, I retweeted it. Because I didn't know what she was saying, but it sounded smart.
The cop out of the retweet?
Yeah, yes. Way to put me on the spot there, bud.
I'm sorry.
And then the self-deprecating BizNasty2point0 says, took Ryan Nugent Hopkins a little less than 3 games to tie my career number in goals.
Yeah, that kid can play. I'm sure they weren't even thinking about sending that kid back to junior.
Listen, we're happy to present you with the Hockey Night in Canada towel. That was your only request coming on the show.
Usually it's for guys that are sweating, but I said, I actually asked for the whole set. I want
the
face
cloths. In your restroom?
Yeah, 100%.
Enough to make a bathrobe or something?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Well, I hate to tell
you guys don't make those?
No. That towel belongs to Mike Smith, and you have to give it back to him in the morning.
Is there sweat already on it?
He had it around his neck.
eBay,
so.
Pay my rent.
Are teammates hesitant around you with the fear that they may have something tweeted about them?
No. Are you referring to the Rafi Torres incident?
No. We weren't going to bring that up.
Okay.
But we can.
Well, basically, no, because when we were at the party, we didn't see anything wrong with it. You know, it was just a guy dressed as Jay-Z. And
well, that was not the intent of the question. I'm just talking about, you know,
in
guys.
General,
yeah,
with
yeah,
guys.
In general.
No, not really, because I know the line.
Yeah.
I think, well, maybe with that Torres incident, guys would think differently, but he wasn't mad about it because, you know, he knows who he is as a person, and yeah.
All right, now we got to explain it. He went as Jay-Z, and his wife went as Beyonce, and Rafi is a huge Jay-Z fan, and he had some dark makeup on, and it led to a great hue and cry, but seems to have passed, fortunately.
It has,
so.
Yes.
Does it bother you, Paul, that you're better known for tweeting as opposed to playing?
No. I'm okay, somewhat, because I get chirped a lot for it. But, I mean, you know, I have a certain role in this team, and we play a certain system. And if, you know, my game permits that I be in the lineup as far as fighting and being physical, then so be it. And if not, you know, I'm just going to continue to work hard and keep a smile on my face because, you know, if I'm not in the room and showing that I'm having a good time and, you know, I'm bringing the other guys down, then it's no good, you know. You need a guy like that.
But it can be difficult because you're not part of the wins, you're not part of the losses. How do you stay connected to it?
Well, he has me warm up every game. Like some guys where their healthy scratch won't warm up, where I'm in the room playing music, you know, joking around, keeping the guys light, where you know, I've embraced that role. Am I frustrated and upset that I'm not playing? Of course, but you know, just be positive, and I'm thankful that I'm in the National Hockey League, because there's a lot of guys out there with more skill, maybe not as good as a fighter, but that could be in my place. So I'm just going to enjoy it and stay positive and embrace it.
Tweet from Dipster T.
All right.
What makes you more famous in Phoenix, hockey or Twitter?
Well, I mean, we don't really get recognized much when we go out. Maybe more so during the winter when all the Canadians come down. But, I mean, there's some bar owners that ask me to shoot out some tweets sometimes and stuff. So, you know, get a few free pops out of that.
Okay. There's another good one.
We're going to detail there.
Yeah, I think I know what you're talking about. Carry on here, Daryl, till I find the next tweet that I'm...
Well, I'm curious, out of all your followers, which ones blow you away the most? Who follows you?
I have a few girls that follow me that are actresses. Jenna Jameson follows me.
Congratulations.
Nikki.
Yes.
Indeed. A couple of guys.
Jenna Jameson is an actress.
Get a standing ovation back there.
Nice. Nice.
Nikki Benz, who is another actress in the same field.
Yes.
The list continues.
We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen.
After hours. Getting after
that's
it.
That's why we call it after
hours.
Yeah,
exactly. Right. You can go there.
I know when you sent that tweet out yesterday, somebody said it's the adult portion of Hockey Night in Canada, and gosh darn it, if you haven't taken that part of it to heart.
Man, I got back some funny tweets about that. I'm like, what goes on in this show? And I can't say on the show, but I was dying laughing.
Tweet from Craig, who is it? Oh, Canuck Son is his handle.
Uh-oh.
As one, and this is a good one, as one of the best tweeters in the NHL, you've received harsh criticism on there as well. Instead of ignoring it, you retweet and reply. Why?
Because I find a lot of people retweet compliments, and to me that's just painful and annoying. And I think it's, some of them are funny, and I'll laugh, but I just think it's fun to kind of get people, and also my followers will turn against them, so it's kind of just fun to chirp them back, stay on my toes, and as well see the people unleash the fury on them. I've had a few people delete their accounts because my fans just bombarded them with tweets.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
The power of Twitter.
One girl chirped me one time and tried to go to the heart on me, and I don't go after girls very often, but she was kind of getting at me, and I let one go, and she was off Twitter like that. So, sorry.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen.
Sorry if you're listening.
Fool around with the BizNasty 2.0 game.
Everyone's fair game if you don't come at me first, that's for sure.
You know your role in the game. The fourth line is your life.
Yes.
And
I actually got you guys
some
gifts. Let's
get to that.
How great is this?
Yeah, that's you can get that on saucehockey.com. Tonight I was on the fifth line, and unfortunately they only play four in the NHL. But usually when I do play, I'm on that line.
New graphics coming?
Yeah, so here, you can
thank
have
you very
that
much.
One. I think I dropped the other one, so I'll give you that one. And we got hats now, too. So
excellent.
Yeah, I mean, you guys don't
and
wear
these
hats.
Are flat brim, right?
Yeah. That's old school.
You can imagine how stupid I'd look in that. But
No.
What is the connection?
Not with that logo on it. You can't. It's impossible.
What is the connection with Sauce Hockey for you?
Sauce Hockey, my friend Eric, who owns a company, he works around the rink here, and he kind of approached me about it, and I was skeptical at first. Yeah, you guys are showing off some of the shirts here. I like the hands like feet.
Well, first of all, it's a clothing line, right?
It is,
that
yes.
has a BizNasty or a Paul Bissonnette
right.
Line, which as far as we can see here is a collection of T-shirts with
right.
a constant play on your fourth line status.
Yeah, and you know, it's just it's fun. I mean, it's making fun of myself a little bit, but we also have some charity T-shirts that go towards the homeless. I'm bringing homeless families to the games all season long. I think we're gonna.
So to use the proceeds of the sales from Sauce Hockey shirts to do that?
The shirts that
I'm
are
trying to justify the shameless plug here.
Yes, well, that most of the other shirts do, but the ones that are specifically for charity do 100%, and the other ones for the profits for me. But I will dip into it and bring fans to the game. 105. Yeah. I brought homeless people to the game last year.
Really?
Fed them, had them transported. Is that how you say that?
Yeah, it's not transported.
I'm with it. Transported, yeah, but
it's blacked out.
Right. You know how on Twitter it shouldn't be all about the proper spelling of things and all that.
Yeah.
People get
people are all over so me with my spelling.
Yeah,
I'm
I
French
saw a
Canadian.
Tweet about that.
I'm French Canadian. Like, give me a break here.
I think you had said something to the effect of anyone criticizes my spelling on my next tweet, he's a what?
Can I say dickhead on television?
You just did.
Okay, there you go.
Testing. Yeah, you can't.
Testing one,
you
two, three.
Why can't you? We've talked about adult films. You can say.
Yeah.
What'd you talk on about after hours yesterday, Paul? I don't know.
Listen, you have a social conscience, clearly, because you frequently feature the homeless in your tweets. I mean, you brought them to games, but you also feature them in your tweets. What's motivated you to do this?
You know what? It started with in Toronto a couple summers ago, where I just saw a lot of them outside. This guy was right off the highway. Loved the sign.
Broken ugly.
Yeah. But no, and I just kind of started tweeting about it, and it just kind of the idea sparked, and you know, why not help out? I deal with CAS AZ, which is a homeless shelter. That's who I'm doing all the proceeds with, and bringing their families to games.
Perfect. You get a lot, as we said earlier, harsh criticism on Twitter. I'm wondering how many times you've heard from people with a tweet along the lines of, you should tweet less and spend more time working on your game.
Yes, I get that a lot, but you can't train 24 hours a day. It's impossible. Yeah. I've never tried it, but I hear it's impossible.
Daryl did it when he played.
Yeah, really?
Look where it got me.
Twitter was invented back then? Yeah. When dinosaurs roamed the earth?
No, we're talking about training.
Okay, sorry. I was up.
But, it was a fax machine, whatever.
I work extremely hard. I think if anyone who knows me knows that, my friends see how committed I am to the game. You know, I have my fun in the summer, but when it comes time to training, you know, I get down to business and, you know, eat healthy, take care of my body, and, you know, Everyone assumes because I'm on Twitter that, you know, I'm just joking around and I don't take hockey seriously. Well, that's not the case. Twitter's for fun. They don't want to hear about how I just finished practice and how hard I worked.
Speaking of your playing, I think we have your first NHL goal.
Oh, it's meat and potatoes.
Isn't it, though?
Oh, that's this thing. And you going to play it?
Yeah, we have it.
Oh, I need it. Well, I need the confidence boost.
As we wait for it, you had a deal with your father here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
He would shave his mustache after you scored your first NHL goal, and he backed out of the deal. Why?
Because I think he got anxiety about losing his stash. But luckily for Movember,
nobody stops that. By the way.
Nobody stopped. Well, I didn't see it. So how would he? Look at this. I'm like, I'm going to get to that. All right.
Well, it was right off your skate.
I tried to celebrate and look, Pisey got right in my way. Boom. Right in his chest. I think he got credited with a hit there too.
But you got to be the first guy in the bump line.
Yeah.
On the bench. That's nothing better than that.
I sprinted to the bench to be the first guy.
I think the reason your father might've backed out of the deal was that, really,
it was
terrible. Him off your skate, and you know, there was not much skill involved.
That could have been it. But
most
then
memorable of the four, though.
No, you know what? My father saw me play my first NHL game in Toronto. I ended up tipping one in to make it. I think it was like 5-1 at the time, and we ended up winning 5-4. Ended up being the game winner, and he was in the crowd. And safe to say, by the time I saw him after the game with my buddies, he was buckled. they were taking Patron shots, and it's been a while since Cam had done those. So yeah. We probably could have pinned him down and shaved his mustache right
then
and there.
Yeah,
we'll make good on the deal. Well, listen, just finish up the Movember challenge with your father.
Whoever's going to grow the biggest mustache, pretty much.
That's Cam, right?
That's Cam in full mustache mode right there. He shaved it. Look at that. I was like, oh my, I don't even recognize this guy. And I haven't had a chance to shave yet, but mine's barely growing in right now. So I'll shave tomorrow and give everyone on Twitter. See, it's kind of pathetic. I'm interested to see where my dad's at, though. I hope it never grows back for him.
Could you imagine?
Yeah. He shaved it. He didn't wax it.
Yeah. My mom gave him a Brazilian upper lip
a
wax.
A lip Brazilian.
Yeah, yoli.
Wow.
Let's go back to how we started this. When I
after
mentioned
hours.
I mentioned the grocery stick. This was you on the street recently in Scottsdale or Phoenix there.
You know what a grocery stick is?
A grocery stick. No,
In a hockey term.
Is it a stick where you hit the whole bag of groceries where you...
No.
I don't know. What is
No, it was a term invented for guys like me who sit on the bench and I sit where the D-men and the forwards split. So they call me a grocery stick. How do you feel about that?
I think you need to move.
You know, people love self-deprecating humor, and you got that part of it mastered. Did that guy have any idea who you were?
No, but I think he was a huge Detroit Red Wings fan, he was saying. So I think we got him tickets to the Red Wings game. Rich Nair got his information. Everyone who we interviewed during those clips, Professor Paul clips, got tickets to games, and I think he was special case where we're going to get him against Detroit.
Professor
and those are high.
Paul.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. no. Doesn't
Edmonton
work.
Edmonton Capers.